there were seven people who are in positions in the temple. They are, since several years I have been observing that they have been acting very negatively against our Vedic dharmas. They have been trying to deviate the rituals, delete certain rituals with the excuse of shortage of time. This happened for about 25 days where the prasadams were prepared outside the original kitchen, and the prasadams were unfit to be offered. And Agam Shastra says the god was starving, made to fast for 25 days, which is the greatest sin in the history of the temple.
Jai Govinda, friends. You know, in our previous video, we exposed the Tirupati temple management, the TTD, and the state government, which is working hand in hand to Christianize the temple and not following the protocols, and also doing a caste-based divide, like a job quota system in temple devotees who come to Tirumala for worship, to divide and destroy Hindus. And you know what? We got so many abuses, threats. I want to say those who abuse us and also, you know, kind of putting fake news. I am going to show you everything, how we are being attacked, just for making sure our temple and our gods are being taken care in the right way, and our desh and our dharma is protected from these forces which try to Christianize our temple and destroy it. And that too, very, very special temple like Tirupati Balaji temple. I just want to say those who abuse Bharat Marg for exposing the divide and destroy strategy of the TTD management, along with the state government support, to say you that you cannot shut our mouth, okay? Because we will be keep exposing you. We are not part of the rice bag gang or the crypto gang to shut down, shut up, and put up, and think whatever happens with our temple, let it be. We don't care. Okay, I'm going to give a point by point rebuttal for you and the campaign, negative campaign you ran, and you did a press conference. Let us go through each one. I want the viewers to go through this video thoroughly. Before going through this video, make sure you go through our TTD video on the caste divide and the other Tirupati Balaji videos we have put together. Okay, on different videos, we are addressing different things, because see, If we lose Tirupati temple, we lost it all. We cannot afford to lose. Let's go through and make sure you watch all the videos and watch this video and comment after seeing our point by point rebuttal. Do you agree with us? Do you think this is the time to raise our voice and expose and protect our desh and dharma? Do you agree that? Comment here and share it. First, they put out, see, this is our video. Caste-based reservation for Darshan in Tirupati. They call this as a fake news. Can you see that? Caste-based reservation in Tirupati doesn't exist, they say. That's what the fake news means, right? Now, let's see what they are saying in other messages they sent us. Now you see here, TTD has taken a strong objection for misleading the social media campaign by Bharat Marg, a YouTube channel. Okay, of course, we are a digital magazine. We run big way, okay? See, in a clarification on Saturday, TTD said that noble objective to contain a religious conversation, okay? it's the funniest part, okay? This is a Christianized organization where the people with the anti-Hindu mindset are being forced in. We have shown it in our previous video. If you didn't see it, please see it. Okay, and they are working on anti-conversion move. Okay, there is nothing more joke than this. TTD had taken up the program collaborating with foundation to provide Srivari Darisanam to people belonging to SC, ST, BC and fishermen community. from backward regions. Okay, I'm asking, why fishermen communities alone? Why not boating community? Why not barber community? Why not the one who are working in the Shamshan Ghats? Why not them? Why not, why to divide people on communities? This is exactly what we have said. You know, in the caste-based reservation for Darshan in Tirupati. Okay, this is what they called us a Christian, this thing, you know, divide and destroy. This is what they call us fake news, folks. But here they themselves are giving with an excuse on top of it. They are doing the caste-based divide because they want to fight the conversion. Let's show them the mirror. How in the same script, TTD board has resolved to roll out a provision for Vaikundha Dwara Darshanam to SC, ST, BC and fishermen communities in January 2022 during Vaikundha Ekadasi. Okay, see, yeah, they are starting slowly. You know, they did it for Brahmostavam, now they are doing for Vaikundha Ekadasi. And what next? They will have a separate line for each sect is our question. When we asked that, they called it as a fake news. Okay, now then they went on to do a press release. In Times of India, TTD condemns demeaning campaign by YouTube channel. Okay, that is Bharat Marg they are talking about. Okay, and they had to understand why we will put down our own temple, folks. You know, I am a staunch devotee of Balaji. Balaji temple is a place where we have come from the childhood. Why we will put down a temple? No, we are not putting down the temple. We are putting down the management that is doing work to divide and destroy Hindus and Hinduism using this temple and temple money. That's what we are talking about. Temple body to facilitate SC, ST, BC. So, see, you understand. Now for the job quota, if you say remove the quota, the people will, politicians will cry foul, isn't it? They will say, oh, these guys are against SCs, they're against SCs. Same thing is being played here, folks. Same thing is being played here. Okay? So we had to be very, very careful about it. And guess what? TTD clarified the trust board had recently resolved to facilitate this thing, state with a noble intention to propagate Hindu Sanatana Dharma and enforceable religious conversion. Okay, you are going to see the video of one of the ex head priest who is going to give you whole information in this video. So go through it. Okay, and he will go through how the converted rice bank are being inserted inside. These guys will take salary from TTD, they will have a Hindu name, but they won't take a prasad. This is the thing. They will make money from Tirupati temple. They will eat Tirupati money's food, but they will not take prasad. Okay, these are all the kind of people who are inside. And they will have a Hindu name, of course. That's why we call them crypto, isn't it? Accordingly, TTD facilitated the darshan for Brahmostav. Okay, Ekadasi and Dwadasi. First they said Ekadasi. Now they have included Dwadasi too. Okay, in the caste-based divide darshan. Okay, TTD also rebuses another charge leveled by the channel, that is Bharat Marg, that the Hindu temple body was financially supporting Christian pastors and was also providing funds to Jerusalem Hajj Yatras, absolutely baseless. And I want you to see this video, folks. I am going to put the video's link in the description. Make sure to go through. Okay, this was the ticket which had on the back of it Christianity advertisement with the Tirumala tickets. Okay, we exposed this in Bharat Marg, and after which they removed it. And also, guess what? Our team is working on doing a project in Tirupati. Okay, because we love Tirupati, and the Tirupati Balaji is a blessing in our life, but we want to make sure we do our work for our dharma. Okay, our team goes wherever the pujaris are talking. They are totally unsatisfied because they are all kept as a contract workers. They complain that the Brahmin community, that is the archakas, are being abused, you know, by not providing a full-time job. And on the other hand, you know, they say that the drivers get a permanent job, all the other workers get a permanent job, but we work here for ages, but we are still a contract employees. This is the feedback we got from the archakas. Okay, and when we go to put money in the hundi, they themselves say, why do you put it there? Don't give it to us, don't give it here, because it's not going for good cause. okay? But I'm going to show you the video which is going to go through these things, okay? Stick around. You see here, I want you to see this link is going to be there. You go through Christianity advertisement in Thirumala tickets, and after our expose, they pulled back the advertisement because there was a huge uproar that created after Bharat Marg exposed Tirupati Devasthanam, that is a TTD for their illegitimate work on putting together the Christianity advertisement behind all the bus tickets that is exclusively going to Tirupati Balaji temple from the downhills. That means it's a targeted campaign against the Hindu community. Appeal to the devotees not to believe in the Seamer campaign. You know, what is Seamer campaign? We are going to give you the proof, okay? So, you know, stop returning. You know, we will do this, we will do that, and we will do legal action, that, this. You know, make sure you, we have given here a point by point rebuttal and go through action initiated by TTD on this blatantly false post. Cyber crime police are tracking of you. You know, WhatsApp number. We give the WhatsApp number. What's a big deal? You know, you are not doing a kind of a investigation work here. Our WhatsApp number is there everywhere for anybody to contact for dharmic work. Friends, now let me show you the clippings from the ex-head priest, okay, himself, for you to know what is happening inside the temple. You go through it, and whatever you feel, still, if you think, you know, this temple needs a cleanup, go ahead and share the video. You know, share it with as many people till it reaches the right people who are dharmic, who are concerned, you know, who will crack down and save our temple, folks. Because Hindu temples are not free. Our money is being misused. You know, they have a jumbo board. Anybody who cannot be accommodated in any ministerial berth, you know, any, and that jumbo board came now with the Christian management, because you know what? They wanted to make sure our temple money is being misused. Okay, jumbo board. You know, anybody, there is no limit. You know, they put any number of people so that they get the car, their wife get the car, their PA get the car, they get the fuel. All are hundi money, folks. Go and see our video called Satyagraha. Okay, I will request you never put money in the government occupied temples, folks. If you do it, you are funding Hajj Yatra, you are funding conversion, and you are funding all those things which you don't like. Instead, you go to a Tirtha Sthal and give the money to somebody else who deserve it. Okay, maybe some poor person, maybe some beggar sitting there, get them couple of times of food. Okay, yeah, anything that you can do, but don't put the money in the hundi, folks. Now listen to the head priest.
Not only with this TTD board, but there were so many persons in the temple. The board meets only once in a month and takes decisions, policy decisions. But there were certain people who are in positions in the temple. They are, since several years I have been observing that they have been acting very negatively against our Vedic dharmas. They have been trying to deviate the rituals, delete certain rituals with the excuse of shortage of time on waiting pilgrims. And they have been trying, like the kitchen incident, they have tried to prepare the prasadam somewhere outside in the next prakaram and bring it to the sanctum through the way where all the devotees are touching the prasadams, and thus the prasadam becomes unholy and not suitable to be offered to the deity. But they have been brought into the sanctum and presented to be offered to the deity, which as the according to Agam Shastras, the deity refuses to accept. And so this happened for about 25 days, where the prasadams are prepared outside the original kitchen, and the prasadams were unfit to be offered. And Agam Shastra says the god was starving, made to fast for 25 days, which is the greatest sin in the history of the temple. And all these things were directed by some persons inside the temple, notion of polluting the positive spiritual energy inside the temple and make the deity weak, and basically destroy the concept of temple, and which makes the visit of the devotees to the temple not worth, because when the god is starving and in an angry mood, the devotees will never be blessed, and there is possibility that it causes so many calamities, both natural and man-made calamities, throughout the state, throughout the country. And already we are facing political instability and huge rise in violence throughout the world, and loss of life and destruction of forests, and there is occurrence of strange diseases throughout the world. And all these things are the result of the anger of the wrath of gods, which are caused by a few people in the temple. So these people have to be kicked out of the temple immediately if the government is really concerned of protecting our Vedic Dharma, as they have promised in their election manifestos, creating the protecting the temple culture, our ancient traditions, Vedic Dharma, our Sanatan Dharma. But it's not happening. They are encouraging the other religions by destroying our Vedic religion.
How do you think this can be cleaned up?
Yes.
Only by the government, or devotees can protest, or how does it work?
Devotees can protest, but the devotees were also fed with wrong information by certain news channels which are supportive of the state government. They are not giving the right news, the correct news to the devotees, correct directions to the devotees, and they are acting in a negative way. They see whatever contempt I have expressed, that the rituals are diluted, or the temple treasure has been being looted, and the temple funds is being misused by the board and the government. All these things they are not bringing to the devotees in the right way and in the right standard. The state government should immediately act if they are interested in protecting the Sanatana Dharma and our Hindu Dharma, being claiming as Hindus. They should kick out all these negative personalities in the temple and entrust the management of the temple to a really spiritual board, where the members are philanthropists, spiritual people, swamijis, and most important, the archakas, the priests who were directly performing the rituals, to have the liberty to perform all the rituals according to the shastras, and entrust that peace is maintained inside the temple and Lord is kept happy, so that the state and country, the entire world is peaceful with the blessings of the Lord.
Jai Sri Ram. And you know what? With you, we will be able to clean up the temple, folks. And we will be able to do only with you, only with your support. Yeah, go through it, come and share, and let's join hands to spread the message of Sanatana Dharma in its purest form around the world, and we will not be taken advantage. Jai Sri Ram.